This is the new 200 watt Anker Prime power bank, which is a part of Anker's newest lineup of chargers and portable batteries. With a 20,000 mAh battery capacity, two USB-C ports, one USB-A, a smart LCD display to check battery health and status, and up to 200 watts of total power output, this thing packs a ton in a really small form factor. It fits right in my hand like this, it's even shorter and narrower than my phone, and surprisingly not as heavy as it looks. This is all thanks to the stack design inside, made up of four 5,000 mAh batteries, which is pretty insane. It doesn't look and feel half bad either with a solid, dense build, so with all that said, I'm sure a lot of you are already thinking about adding this to your everyday carry or travel carry, and I am too. Well, Anker is promising a lot with this, and even though this is a sponsored video paid by Anker, I'm gonna let you guys know all the ins and outs, actually put it through some real world tests, and see if it's really legit. So just to clarify, 200 watts is the total possible power output. None of the individual ports on here can get to 200 watts, but using them together, even simultaneously, can get you a total of 200 watts. Each of the USB-C ports are capable of power delivery 3.0 up to 100 watts, and the USB-A can get up to 65 watts of output. When using them all together at once, one USB-C port gets up to 100 watts, the other gets up to 60 watts, and the USB-A gets up to 40 watts, which is a total of 200 watts. But when using just the two USB-C ports, you can get up to the max 100 watts for both ports, which is again a total of 200 watts. And when using one USB-C and one USB-A at once, you get the max 100 watts for USB-C and the max 65 watts for USB-A. Even though you can't get 200 watts with a single port, each port is still pretty powerful enough to charge most laptops and phones at their peak charging speeds, so this power bank is really flexible and versatile in that way. On top of that, you can charge the Anker Prime itself at up to 100 watts, either through the USB-C ports, since they also take up to 100 watts of input, or through the pins at the bottom with the optional charging dock, which is a cool option. Okay, now let's actually go test this thing out and see if Anker's promises are really true. So this is a M3 MacBook Pro 14, and I've only got about 14% left. I'm at a cafe, not really close to any power outlets, so I'm going to try charging this. The smart display actually tells you how fast it's charging, which is super useful, but just as a double measure, I did use a power meter to see if it's legit, and it seems so. I also love how you can keep your table decluttered since the power bank is small, and you can just use the included short cable like this. Okay, let's charge this thing up as much as we can and see where we're at. Okay, 20 minutes later, the power bank is now empty, but we're now at 49% for the MacBook Pro. That's legit really good from a small power bank to charge up this big, power-heavy laptop from basically 15 to 50% in just 20 minutes. The power bank only had about 75 to 78% left in the tank when it started charging the MacBook Pro, so that means it could have had about 10 to 15 extra minutes of charging if it was at 100%. And throughout the charging, it was able to reach peak charging speeds, which is 96 watts for this laptop, and the power bank stuck to a temperature range about 45 to 47 degrees Celsius, so it stayed fairly cool and it's definitely not enough to burn your life. Okay, now my Galaxy S24 Plus also seems a little low, so let's try charging it. The S24 Plus can charge up to 45 watts with a compatible charger. Thankfully, with Anker's Power IQ 3.0, the Anker Prime is fully compatible with Samsung's fast charging, and also with other ultra-fast charging protocols like SuperVOOC charging from Oppo. Most of my charging bricks at home definitely can't do that, so that's awesome. Alright, so from 15%, let's see where we're at in 30 minutes. Okay, 30 minutes later, from 15%, we're now at 62% on the Galaxy S24 Plus, and the power bank itself only drained from 100 to 63%. For charging my large screen phone, this thing just blazed through it and only just sipped on its own battery life. In other words, the Anker Prime can handle about 2 to 3 full charging sessions for most phones. So if you're looking to carry this around when traveling to charge up you and your friends' phones, this will be a very reliable option. Now those tests were pretty easy, but let's take it up a notch and see how this thing handles two laptops at the same time. When connected to both a MacBook Pro 14 and a MacBook Air 13 at the same time, the charging speed is maxed out for both, and I can double confirm that with the power meters. Pretty crazy at a power bank that's as compact as this. Okay, so let's actually charge these up and see how much they fill up. Alright, 24 minutes later, the power bank is now empty, but the MacBook Pro went from 10 to 38% and the MacBook Air went from 11 to 43%. The Air didn't lose any charging speed throughout this time. The MacBook Pro did slow a bit once the power bank got a little warm, but it still kept at it at half the pace at around 45 watts. Even with two laptops low on battery, the Anker Prime filled them up enough to basically get you through for that extra mile of work, which is pretty damn impressive from something this size. It did get a little toasty towards the end, up to 54 degrees, but really nothing to worry about here. Let's go up another level and use this to charge my LCD Steam Deck, which is notorious for its poor battery life and pretty slow charging speeds. I only have like 16% left, and I'm going to play Uncharted 4 for the next hour and see if this power bank can keep it alive. Alright, 1 hour and 15 minutes later, we're now at 54%, so I successfully kept my Steam Deck alive and it even charged it up some. That's awesome. I also noticed it stuck to 35 to 40 watts of charging, which is basically full speed. Really impressive stuff. I think I can finally play my Steam Deck on longer flights, which I couldn't really imagine before. Okay, but how about charging the power bank itself? Really, the most annoying part about carrying power banks is that a lot of them charge so slow and you kind of just stop using them because of that. Well, with 100 watts of input charging available here, Anker is promising quick charging times. So let's test that out and see if it's true. Okay, so charging with a 100 watt adapter, the Anker Prime went from 0 to 100% in just 50 minutes. It stayed relatively cool throughout from 27 to 43 degrees Celsius, and while I noticed the speed slowing down the warmer it gets, it still kept at a good pace and this filled up way faster than I thought it would. So that's super convenient for a battery this size and really makes it easier for me to carry this around and not worry about it being out of charge all the time. Also, shout out again to the smart display since I can easily check the battery life and estimated time remaining. Way more useful than just some LED lights. Okay, so that's it for all my tests using the Anker Prime Powerbank. Even though this is a sponsored video, these were real tests with real results for things I actually use powerbanks for, and I think the results speak for themselves. So I'm personally really satisfied with the Anker Prime. I'll be honest, there are competing products with similar touted features or speeds, but considering how reliable every Anker product has been for me and how long I use their products for, I personally do have way more trust in buying a powerbank from Anker more than any other brand. That's my take. If you're also sold on this, you can go buy your own using the affiliate links down below. It doesn't cost anything extra for you, but it'll help support the channel. Alright, that's going to do it for this video. Let me know what you think of the results here, and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.